Gerry man, why is it always me that does all the hard graft?
Because you're the one with the shovel.
Oh, right. Aye, but even when there are no shovels, it's still always me that does all the big, heavy, horrible stuff.
Aye, that's because you're the one that's big, heavy and horrible. Oh, here, Sewell, man. Watch what you're doing, man. I want straight edges, you know.
What are you on about? It's pitch bloody black, man. You'd have to make do with zigzag, like.
Here. Oh, shite. That was me last one and all. How are you? Activity. Step on it, Sewell, man. Oh, fuck, man, Sewell!
Oh, Jesus. I need some bloody light, man.
United had described last night's theft of a penalty spot from St James's Park as an act of mindless vandalism. Head groundsman Charlie Harrison had just one word for it: sacrilege. Travel and weather coming up.
Well, I don't understand what they're on about.
Sacrilege? It's like, you know, making a mess of something sacred, like.
No, I mean mindless. That's bollocks, man. We put a lot of thought into that. It's like you said, if you can't be a part of it, you might as well take a part of it.
Field of dreams, eh, Sewell, man? We can be part of it. I can see it now, Sewell, man. We'll get in there dead early, like, to soak up the atmosphere. And we'll buy us both a huge cup of tea each. Two sugars, dead milky. And when the magpies come out, we'll get up and go bananas, you know, like you do. And then they'll kick off, and we'll just be there, all comfy-like, sitting in our seats, sipping our tea, watching our tune. Belter, eh?
What are you on about, Gerry, man?
Season tickets.
Season tickets? Us?
Would I? Why not, like?
Why, for one, they don't hand them out on the social, you know. They cost about £500, like, each.
Aye, so?
So? We're about £500 short, like. Each.
Aye, so. You know what you and me need, Sewell, man?
Aye, about £1,000 by the sound of it.
Mission. Oh, wait, what you say, eh? All we get from thieving and twatting. Put it all to one side, like. Anything we can think of for making money, we do. And we didn't chuck it away either. Pack in the tabs, pack in the dope, no booze and no glue. We save everything up for our season tickets. What you reckon, eh? There's a while until the season starts. We can do it easy, man.
Right, you lot, out of here. And you too, you little fuckers. You're not supposed to be up here.
You know what we'll get, Sewell, man, when we get our season tickets? Something you and me have never had.
Proper pies.
Respect, Sewell, man. Are you with us?
Come on, clear off out of it, you fucking little tow rags.
Aye. I'm with you, Gerry, man.
We're kind of feel, man. Especially not with that lass looking after us.
Who?
The guardian angel of fucking tow rags. She'll see us through.
Thank you.
Dad, did you make this from the tap?
Aye, son. Is there something wrong?
Hot's the one on the right, Dad.
Oh. I'll make you another.
No, no. You're all right. I'm off out.
Take your coat off, Sewell pet. You look like you've been lagged.
Am I all right, Thomas and McCartan?
You must be sweating rivers in there, big lad.
What with all that blubber?
I'm all right, Mr. McCartan, honest. I wouldn't feel the benefit, you know.
All right, Sewell.
All right.
All right, Mum. All right, I was Sheila.
Jesus, Mancher stinks.
So did you, Mancher.
I didn't like that, I didn't. I'd remember.
You still do, sometimes.
All right, Claire, what are you up to?
I just got some stuff for Mum, like.
Still no Bridget, then?
Yeah. It's been 3 weeks now.
You all right, Mrs. McCartan?
Never better, Sewell, son. Never better.
Hello, Sewell, man. I'm going.
Hey, y'all.
Wouldn't be school by any chance, would it, son?
I told you, Mum. I'm studying the University of Life, me.
University of Life, my arse. Sewell, man, can you not talk some sense? Nah, I'm asking the wrong person there.
See ya. So what's the plan then, Gerry, man?
Oh, man, give us a chance.
I could murder a tab.
Sewell, man, you've only been given up 10 minutes.
Well, that's a record for me. Oh, Jesus! It's staring us in the face, man.
What is?
Scrap, man, Gerry. The river's full of it, look. Folk are always chucking away things that they don't want.
Aye, they don't want them, because they're useless.
Hand away. There's loads of money in scrap.
It's junk, man.
We've got to start somewhere. Everything in there's worth something. All we've got to do is get in there and pull it out.
We?
Gerry, give us a hand, man.
Out of way, man. One of us has got to look respectable if we're going to sell anything. First rule of scrap dealing. You might make money out of shite, but you can't go around smelling other stuff.
I'm trapped. Gerry, man, I'm singing. Gerry.
Watch, mud monster, and you shall learn. Practical science-like. If you stopped at school, you'd know these things. I'll get the bug out first, and then I'll come back for you.
Eh?
Second rule of scrap dealing. Leave the real shite till last.
Shit.
Dragonborn!
You're embarrassing, man.
I'm embarrassing? Look at you. Anyway, do you want these season tickets or not?
Wait, of course I do, more than anything.
Dragonborn! Any old Dragonborn!
You're not the usual. Does Terry know you're doing this? You know, Terry, the gadget who normally comes round.
Oh, you mean Uncle Terry? Why, I?
Had a way, you lying bastards. Come in, lads, I've got something for you. Is that the new look, then? Yeah. Pebble Dash, you look like you've been stood the arse end of an elephant, you. Away, you bastards. Any sons. I wouldn't care, but it's a different one every week. 14 of them there was in the house last night. The stink, no. But I can't do out about it. He gans mad if I mention it. Anyway, lads, this is what you can take. Snap it, like. Oh, get hold of the bastard! Quick! Shite! You'll murder me, you will. His favourite, that. He'll get mad if that one's not in when he gets back.
What's he doing in a fridge like? He's a home man. Not a bloody penguin.
That one'd be in the microwave if I had one. See you, lads. If I live.
See ya. Ta.
Thank you.
take after your granddad, you do. No words. Just all dribble and puke. Oh, never mind. Your nana's here, pet. Your nana'll always be here for you. Shall I sing to you? Shall I sing, my little shearer? I cannot get to my love if I should dee, for the waters of time run between him and me. Leave it. And here I must stand with a tear in my eye.
Not all phone calls are bad, you know.
Claire, pet, I'd know if I'd won the bloody lottery. Both sighing and sickly, my true love to see. Now, it'll be the social, or the school, or the loan sharks.
Or Bridget.
Or your dad. Oh, where is the boatman, my bonny hinny? Oh, where is the boatman? Bring him to me, to ferry me over the tyne to my hinny. Oh, scull him across that rough river to me.
Are you sure this fella's gonna buy this stuff?
Why, aye.
Wait, who is he?
Ginga. He's made a mint out of scrap.
Oh, aye. And this'll be one of his many branches nationwide, then, eh?
You'll have to knock louder. I think he's getting deaf, old Ginga.
Aye, wait. Tycoons can't have everything. Hold on to this, then.
You must be canny hot in that snorkel jacket, Harry Sewell's lad.
It's a bench coat, Ginga.
A bench coat?
A bench coat. A training jacket. You know, like what all them footy managers wear.
Fucking bandages? What are you talking about?
We've got you some stuff.
Jesus, I'm not deaf. I know. I've seen it. A knackered old fridge in a busted bog.
Bit of super glue, like. Be good as new, man.
Oh, aye. Thanks very much, lads. Very nice of you to bring it round.
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Well, thought you might pierce, like.
I've no money, lads. I'm what's known as living beyond the cash economy. All right, then. Tell you what I'll do. I'll take the fridge off you in exchange for out round here that you fancy.
Well, what a cracking start that was, eh? Sweating and heaving all day, carrying cartloads of crap all over Tyneside, and what do we get out of it? A fucking cuckoo clock.
Oh, where? A magpie cuckoo clock?
Oh, aye. Thank Christ for that, eh? Wouldn't want to think we was wasting our time, like.
Jesus, murderer tag me. Oh, it's that hound. Here, boy, come to Sewell.
Must have been trailing us.
You mean following the stench of your coat?
No, he just likes us, that's all. I think I'll call him Rusty.
You can't keep him, man. He belongs to Matthew Brabin, and you saw what a raggy mad lad he is. He even scares his own ma shitless.
Look at him. He's dead intelligent, man.
Intelligent? Oh, aye. Well, let's see. Let's test it out, then. Now then, you smelly hound.
Rusty.
Oh, aye. And now then, Rusty, you smelly hound. How many pounds does a season ticket cost?
He cannot answer that, man.
Well, he would do if he was intelligent, because he'd be able to tap the number out with his feet.
The £500, man? He'd have knee bloody feet left. No, he knows the answer. He's just too smart to want to go about on stumps, that's all. Here, I'll show you. All right, Rusty, listen. This is Gerry, the brains behind our mission to get two season tickets, which, as you well know, cost £500 each. So tell us, how many pounds do you think we've got so far, like, eh? Eh? Correct.
From now on, Sewell, we don't waste a minute, not a second. And from now on, leave the bright ideas to me, right?
Right.
Right.
As the folks along the road, just as here we stand.
Great hour, Gerry. Are you Sewell, innit?
Aye, you?
What's up?
Mum's been on the phone. She's poorly, so I'm taking her out to the doctor's.
Don't you worry, Gerry, lad. Just me annual MOT, you know.
Are you? Not going to school?
Don't be daft, Claire, man. I have more periods than he does.
So, what are you doing today, then?
We've got plans, like.
They're up with something like these two. I don't know what it is, but it's not helping our biddies across the road. I know that much.
Oh, Gerry, be an angel pet and look after Shearer for us.
Usual five alike.
Jesus, man! What do you want this early in the morning?
To count our money.
We agreed to, woman. No count until the first day of the season.
That's tomorrow.
Three gas specials. One with not too much chili on, like, for the burn, like.
Hiya, Gerry. All right?
All right, Gemma.
Hey, Sewell, I haven't seen you for ages. Are you upped out? Hey, bloody hell, you have been.
I've not Sewell's man, Gemma. It's all Claire's.
Oh, aye. Hey, can you? Oh, she's got a rattling old. What's she called?
Shearer.
Oh, not another Shearer. They're everywhere, man. Oh, well, I wish it was mine. Do you know Zach? He's the gold minder for Whitley Bay Warriors. We're out celebrating.
Celebrating?
Aye, look.
Aye, can he?
Aye, can he? So when's the happy day like?
End of next year sometime. Soon as I'm 16. Oh, you used to are brilliant. Looking after the bairn. I'd say you are a new man, so we'll pet. If it wasn't for that old coat, like.
Come on, Jim.
See you later, lads.
Later.
Three guys are specials.
Sewell, man, you didn't still fancy her, do you?
What do you not like?
No, not when she's gone out with a gorilla. And the rest.
Eh?
I gave you a 20.
Probably you never.
Aye, I did.
You didn't?
He did.
Jesus, I didn't see them that often, but I do know what the bloody look like, man. She's not thirsty, Sewell, man.
Eh?
Jesus, man, can you not smell it?
Smell what?
Shit.
Oh, that.
It's all clear. Gone with you, lads. Gone with you. And for God's sake, breathe through your mouths.
We take a man, Sewell.
What's he doing?
Jesus. Get upwind, all of you. Sewell, man, whip some of that off quick.
Mum, you're right. Claire says you're not good, like. Where's the telly? Oh, Dad, you bastard.
You bloody Auntie Maudie, old cow. Got a fucking gob on her like the Tyne Tunnel.
What's he taking this time? Did he go into Bridget's womb?
You don't think I got this for now, do you?
I'll put the kettle on here.
You'll have to go and buy one first.
Have you rang the social?
Not with. Oh, come here, Gerry. You skive school, you. You nick all sorts. Drink all sorts. You smoke, I don't know what. You do nothing new except drive your poor mum mad. How that bastard ever produced a lad as good as you, I'll never know.
To, you know, treat it as, well, a fresh start. Clear the decks in your mind and start again.
I really like the crack record, you. You said that the last time and the time before. He'll find us again, man. He always does. He might be a monster, but he's not a fucking idiot.
He won't find you here.
You're wasted in social work, you. You should be a comedian.
We're only trying to make things better for you.
Ah, you know. I know you're doing your best. It's just, well, nothing ever changes, does it?
Aye, it does. The houses get smaller.
Aye. So does the family.
Still no word from Bridget.
Well, there never will be now, will there? Because we can't tell anyone where we fucking live.
We are trying our best for you, Gerry. You do know that, don't you? Oh, talking of which, to go along with a fresh start, I've got a proposition for you.
Maureen, man, I'm too young for you. You wouldn't last past the wedding night.
No, it's just a little trade. You do something for me, I've got something for you. Something I know you'll like.
Maureen, I'm not going to school. Purely no chance.
Oh, listen, Gerry, if you go for, say, just 2 weeks...
Maureen, no.
Listen to our Gerry, son.
Mum, I'm not going to school. It's a hellhole. You get taught nout, and all you get treated like is shite.
Well, according to you, you get that everywhere.
Aye, maybe, but I don't have to dress up like a prick to get it.
So you don't want to know what I've got for you if you go?
No, because I'm not going.
I bet you do. In fact, I bet you're there today, dressed up like a prick. 2 weeks? That's all you've got to do to get this... certain something?
I don't care what you've got, Maureen. I'm not going. Watch me mouth. I am not going to school. Not today, nor any other day. And there's nowt you can do that'll make us change my mind, all right?
Nowt?
Totally nowt.
Well, I never. Gerry McCartan turning down a pair of free tickets to the football.
Be innocent of the knowledge, dearest Chuck. Till thou applaud the dead.
The deed.
The deed. Come, sealing light.
Sealing night.
Scarf up the tender eye of pitiful day, and with thy Bloody invincible hand.
Bloody and invisible.
Cancel and tear to pieces that great bond which keeps me pale. Light chickens and the claw makes wing to the lucky wood.
Carton, don't push me, all right? What can you not read, lad? Maybe you're just lost without the pictures, eh? Janine, you take over. McCartan, just stick to comics, eh?
Light thickens and the crow makes wing to the rookie wood. Good things of day begin to droop and drowse, whilst night's black agents to their prayers do rouse. Thou marvels at my words.
Where's the other lad, then?
I don't know.
Aye, well, if you want the same money, you've still got to plan them all.
Read?
Aye, read.
I don't want any gravy.
You don't want any gravy?
I don't want any gravy.
There you are.
I'm not eating that.
What's up now?
Carton, get a move on. You're holding everything up.
But did you see what you did?
Don't argue, lad. Just get on with it. Bloody waste of space, that one.
I don't know if I can stand it, Sewell, man. Cade's been a right old bastard. And that means we'll get to see the tune, like, but I don't know.
It's only for a fortnight.
Aye. Why, I just want to chin him all the time, like.
Why, chin him in a fortnight? 50p for the guy.
And what's up with you, like?
Why, it's only September, man.
Aye. Well, that's a motor, like. Be prepared.
Cheap buggers.
£1 for the guy.
First times. Gemma, first time you
did the lottery, miss?
Okay, first time you did the lottery. Describe what happened and use a simile. Remember what a simile is? When you say something is like something else.
It was like, well, it was like a disaster, miss.
A disaster?
We decided to use our birthdays as the numbers. You know, all six of our birthdays. My dad went down the shop and did the ticket leg. And we're all tuned in, and it started. You know, with that gadget you see and activate the balls and all that.
Yes, hilarious. Go on, Gemma.
Well, when the numbers come up, we'd won. We're all jumping up and down, celebrating, going mad and that. Except me dad, like.
Why not your dad?
Because he'd forgotten our birthdays, miss. Got down the shop and gone brain dead. Forgot our Dean's birthday, forgot my birthday, and forgot me mum's birthday.
Oh, dear. So how did that feel? And use a simile. When you thought you'd won, and then you realised your father had used different numbers, how did that feel? What did it feel like?
Like a fucking great kick in the cunt, I'd imagine.
Thank you, Gerry. We don't need quite such vivid comparisons.
Aye, but he's right, miss. Good similarity, that.
And what about your father? His perspective on the same experience must have been very different to yours, yeah?
Nobody knows, miss. He's under the patio.
Okay. Anyone else? First times? Thank you, Malcolm. We've already had your all too graphic recollection of the morning after your first vindaloo. Gerry, what about you? You must have a first time experience you can share with us. Oh, surely. All the things you get up to. Come on, anything. What do you enjoy? What's your real passion?
A footy, miss. He's footy mad.
Oh, yeah, that's right. A regular little member of the Toon Army, aren't you, Gerry?
Not anymore, miss. You kind of get in now.
No, but you did used to go, didn't you?
Of course I did, miss.
Well, right. What about the first time you went to football? I bet that was an experience. Why don't you tell us about that? Who did you go with, your dad?
How are you, Gerry? Tell us.
Well, I can't remember that well, miss. It was that long ago. I was small. Dead small, you know.
Try it, Gerry.
I was maybe 5 or 6. I can't remember exactly. There was loads of people. People everywhere. Dead noisy, but having a laugh, you know. Well, we won, I think.
Go on, what else do you remember?
My father's coat. I remember my father's coat. It was dead thick and warm, like a snorkel jacket, you know. I was cold, you see, miss. So my father gave us his jacket, and I put it on right by my face. I'd never been so warm. The wind was whistling round the ground. It was raining and all. Didn't bother me, though. I was cushy. And my father kept looking on down from time to time to see if I was all right. He was shivering in a shirt and jumper-like. But he didn't mind, as long as I was warm.
That's good of him.
Aye. Then at half-time, he bought us both 2 huge steaming cup of teas. We drank them together.
What was the tea like?
Belter. Purely belter. 2 sugars. Dead milky-like. Dunno about similes, miss. It was just like the best cup of tea I've ever had. Then after the whistle went, we stayed put after everyone else had gone. We walked through a park to get on a bus. It was the time of the year when it was getting dark, about 5, you know. And there was this bird singing in a tree. I don't know what sort, miss. Maybe it's one of them thrushes, like. Whatever it was singing dead loud. Just as it were getting dark. It was Mintman.
And what about your father? His perspective on the same experience must have been very different to yours, yeah?
Should think so. He's a fucking pisshead, miss.
Okay,
where we're going?
We'll do CNAs, Smiths, Boots, Marks and Sparks.
Everything's a pound.
Why aye, everything's a pound.
Well, what's funny about that, like?
Sewell, man, we're going nicking things to sell, for proper money, like.
Aye, and all that.
So how much do you think people are going to give us for something we've nicked from a shop called Everything's a Pound?
Depends on what it's worth, like.
Well, how much do you think it's worth coming from a shop called Everything's a Pound?
I don't know. They've got some good gear in there.
The most expensive thing, Sewell, man. How much do you think that's worth? Or for that matter, the cheapest thing.
Jesus, one at a time, man.
It's the same bloody question, man.
Eh?
Look, I'll give you a clue, right? The shop's called Everything's a Something.
I know what the bloody shop's called, Gerry, man.
Aye, well then, everything's a pound. Not everything's a tenner or everything's a different price. Everything's a pound. So how much do you reckon the dearest thing is and the cheapest thing is in a shop called Everything's a Pound?
Well, which do you want, man, the dearest or the cheapest?
Both, man.
Eh?
A pound! A fucking pound! Everything is a fucking pound!
I know that, Jesus. I'm not stupid, man.
All right, Einstein, you're clear on the plan. While they're busy watching me, doing me decoy bit, filling me pockets, you fill yours properly.
Oh, right, aye, because they won't see me, because I'm blind.
Of course they'll see you, man. They just won't suspect you.
Why is that like?
Because you're blind!
All right, aye, I see. Joke, man, Gerry, it were a joke.
Thank you.
just browsing.
That's an unusual guide dog. Where was he trained?
In Wickham.
Oh, I know Wickham. Whereabouts?
In the woods up there, you know?
Woods?
Aye. And all them fields round about.
Strange.
Why is that like?
Well, you know, they usually train guide dogs in towns and cities. On streets. Where people live.
Not this one, because I live in a field, like.
You live in a field?
Aye. Woods, like. Woods. Trees, you know. Out in the wilds, like.
Well, whereabouts?
You wouldn't know it. I live miles from anywhere. We ponies and huskies, them Newfoundland dogs and all, with the webbed feet. Snows most of the year. Big castles.
Browsing, you say?
Aye, just browsing.
Just browsing?
Aye. Not deaf, are you?
No, I'm not deaf. And you're not blind. Stop!
Want to buy some books?
No, thanks.
No, wait, take a look at them first, man. Beauty in it.
We don't do Spanish here.
So?
So? Why would I want a Spanish dictionary?
I don't know. You might want to go to Spain for your holidays. Are you supposed to shag the Diego lads if you didn't know the lingo like? All right, how about this then? A hardback. A classic. See, it even says every man's classic. A sportsman's notebook.
What's it about?
Footy. Keegan wrote it before he left the tomb.
So it's here, it's written by Ivan Turgenev.
Well, he helps him out, like. He couldn't do everything on his own, our Kev. Ivan helped him, like. You know Ivan Turgenev. Can he play? He looks like a fish, but, you know.
How much?
About 800, though, I think, from Dynamo Kiev.
For the book.
McCartan! What are you playing at? You're supposed to be changing in the gym.
I've got no decent kit.
I've got no decent kit, sir.
Well, that makes two of us, then.
See, McCartan? This kid's here. Good kids who come in every day for years and years. Sometimes gone out the far end with nothing. You turn up for a fortnight, and what do you get? A bloody present. I have heard all about it. All these kids, you see, they come here to get educated. But you come here to get football tickets. You know what that makes me feel, McCartan? Fucking sick, that's what. There's only one thing I can do to make myself feel better. And that's to make this fucking fortnight a fucking misery for you. Stop up there, little bear.
Hey, come on, you're chasing the ball around like a flock of sheep. Let's see some positional play. Two backs, one on
four. You should have seen us coming. Passing the folks along the road just as they were scanning. All the lads and lasses then, all with smiling faces, running on the Scotswood Road to see the bleeding faces.
Gerry, man, where are you going? It's the house at the end of the song. We always do the house at the end of the song.
Not tonight, Sewell, man. Oh, stop that humming, man.
I can't help it, man. If I'm buzzing, I'll start humming.
Oh, wait, a vid in the bedroom. They're well loaded.
Hey, look at this tackle. Lily of the Valley.
Lasses will be all ours with this gear on.
No, they won't. It's air freshener, man. You don't spray air freshener on.
Oh, you can.
No, you can't. It's for when you've been, man. To clear the air, like.
Been? What are you on about, man?
You spray it all around after you've had a shite. If you go about with that gear on, the lasses will think you've just done one. Oh, put it back, man. You don't bring it to a house to nick air freshener.
You do if you live with my dad. I think this was gold dust.
Oh, well, let's get downstairs.
Jesus, look at this. They don't even have to wash their own dishes. They just stick them in here, look. Look, a coffee maker. Is it a toaster, a microwave? Jesus, don't these bastards do anything for themselves?
Oh, here, Sewell. We'll have that microwave as something for our dinner. That'll be better for our money tin.
You always say never again, and we always end up going. Whenever a lady she calls.
Oh, not that again, pet.
Yes, that again. It's
okay.
I'm not saying that you fancy a poor man. I mean, who would fancy an old tart like that with her tongue and her tits hanging out?
Denise, I don't fancy her.
Oh, well, for someone who doesn't fancy her, you spend an awful lot of time looking at her tits.
I bet you wasn't all.
Why would I? When my wife's got the top tits on Tainsay.
Honest?
Uh-huh.
Well, are you going to tell them that?
Come on, then.
Oh, Amy and Anna Beauty.
What the hell was that?
Run for it! Oh, fuck it! Run, man! She's at the freaking door!
Tickets, please.
Two and a dog to the football ground.
There you go, son. Cheers now.
Thanks. Oh, man, I got them for free, didn't I? I was con, man. How was I supposed to know?
Well, I don't know, do I? You're meant to be the brains. I can't believe it.
She knows nothing at all about football. Maureen, the old trout. Two free tickets, she said. She didn't say we're for. We're not going there to see them. We're going there to sell our tickets. We'll get good money for these and all. All the ones tickets that we friggin' want.
Just can't believe. We're going to Sunderland.
How are you, man? Stadium of light.
Stadium of shite, you mean?
We're in the heart of enemy territory now. Don't speak a word from now on, right? Not a word.
Man alive, man.
See?
What?
You speak pure Geordie, man. Open your mouth like that around here when you're dead meat. The liberty shreds, man. And afterwards, all we'll find of it is a few scraps of your bench cord blown along the local beach, okay? Want a ticket? Oh, man, Sewell. Should we just go in and watch them?
Eh? Watch Sunderland?
But it's not like we're going to sell our tickets now, is it?
What the fuck, where you come from?
They've already got them.
I suppose. Now better to do, like.
Stay, Rusty. We'll be back at 4:45.
Dogs kind of tell the time, man.
Come on.
in St James is like, but aye, so-so.
Next season, this will be us at St James's. Of course, the football will be much better, like, but you still get a sense of it here. I came to the job again this morning, so we're almost there, son. We're almost there. Tell us that thing again, Sewell, man.
What thing?
You know, about the time your daughter took you to St James's.
Oh, that. Why, man?
Neil Leeson, I was just like it, that's all.
Why, it were years ago. In them days, anyone could go. You didn't have to be loaded. Just peered at the gate, stood anywhere you wanted. We were dead cold, brass monkeys. I remember that. And I remember, my dog gave us his jacket, even though many were cold. He kept on looking down to see if I was all right. He were freezing his bollocks off in a jumper like. But he didn't mind, as long as I was warm. At half-time, he bought her a cup of hot tea, two sugars, dead milky. Better than this one, different class. Well, the best cup of tea I've ever had. Afterwards, we stayed put for a while, stood in the empty ground, just me and him. We were in knee hurry. Then, we went for a walk through the park like, and there was this bird singing in a tree, dead loud like. I remember that. Then, we went home, that was it.
Was it the best day of your life?
Why, I don't know yet, do I?
Sewell, man.
Aye.
This is my first football match. I've never been before. Never even seen the tune play me.
I know that, you dozy get.
Mom? Bridge? Oh, a bridge. I know it's you, man, sis.
All right, Gerry. Come on in, son. Come and say hello to your old man, eh?
Those are hers, and that was mine?
Oh, grow up, son. Besides, all them years I fed and clothed you, all them times I helped you out, you fucking owe to us, son.
You can't do this.
Oh, you gonna stop us? Don't be a prick all your life, son. Eh? I mean, you're no bigger now than the last time I decked you. How's your mom? I still love her. You know that.
Oh, aye. I saw her lip last time you came. Must have been some fucking kiss, that.
You might not like this, Gerry, son. She still loves me. She does, man. I can tell. And I'll tell you something else, son. We're all gonna be back together sooner than you know it. Back like before. Where's Bridge?
How did you find us?
See what I mean? Hey, you never guess, son. Go on. You never guess. What do I do, Gerry, son? What's me job, man? The bins. The bins. You move to my patch, man, you pillocks. I mean, how much fucking easier can she make it, eh? She must want us back.
You bastard!
So this is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, and a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas, I hope you had fun. The near and the dear,
it's a good one, eh, Maureen?
Absolutely.
Without any fear. Gerry, pet Beanie and she'll shut them curtains for us.
So that's what you're saying? You fell down the stairs?
Aye.
It's hard to buy that one.
How's that like?
Well, seeing there weren't any stairs, like... I don't understand. You could get him this time. Get a court order on him.
It's not a court order he wants. It's last rites.
Well, I don't think we could arrange that.
Oh, I don't know. You managed to mix up Newcastle and Sunderland. I think you can manage anything, you lot.
I know it's not the Ritz, but anyways, Kushti, were you here? Just Belder, to have a place to ourselves. Just you and me, you know?
Aye. Just you and me. And Rusty.
Rusty'll be the bother, man.
Hey, you know that mad kid I told you about? The one looking for his dog? Apparently he's asking about, like, looking everywhere. He's off his head, that lad.
Aye, we. So would I be if somebody had nicked me hound.
I don't think it was nicked. He just lost it, like.
Aye. Like you lost that Zach fella, eh?
Aye, like that.
You have lost him, haven't you? Haven't you, Gemma?
Aye, he's gone for good, Zach has. History. I can't be doing with toss as me.
Give us a kiss then, eh, Gemma?
What?
Now? Hey, I got you a Christmas present.
Oh, so you shouldn't have.
It's only small, like. But it's getting bigger all the time.
You said it. Hey, a cock's not just for Christmas, you know. It's for life.
I wouldn't mind that, Gemma Pet.
Are you going to get out of that bench coat or what?
Not if I needn't, no.
Please. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to see the castle win away. Hey,
sweet. I'm 17, man.
Merry Christmas, lads.
Aye, and a happy new hearing aid.
Ta, son, same to you.
Aye, wee, I'm off.
Where to?
Out and about. We've done all right, yeah? We've got to be nearly there now.
Aye, nearly there.
Come on, Rusty.
Sewell, man.
Aye.
Nout. See ya.
See ya.
Stone.
What's up, son?
You've put Christmas pud in the... No matter, eh? Saves time, like. All ends up in the bog together, doesn't it?
Cheer up, will you? It's New Year's, man. We're off for a day out in Whitley Bay.
You're in one of the new flat.
Near our grand total. Toon's fourth in the league, man.
Hey, and soon we can get back on the good things in life, too. So I'm telling you, man, I'm desperate now. Aye. First thing we do, I've got our tickets. A bit of tap, man. A bit of booze. Go out and get totally peeved. Pure raggy, man.
So
wrecked, smashed, eh?
So
mortal, man. Pissed and stoned as fart, eh?
Jesus, Sewell, man! There is no season tickets, and there never will be. My old man found the money and took it.
All of it?
Just after the Sunderland match.
Sunderland? That was months ago, man. And you're just telling us now?
You had a canny Christmas, didn't you?
Well, aye, but...
Well, that's why. Because I didn't tell you. Look, I've got the money with us, what we've saved since, like. So if you want to spend it, I'll understand. Have it, man. It's yours. My father's a bastard, and that's all there is to it. So just take it and be done.
Gerry! You can't give up on a mission. We're going down to Boozer, eh? How'd you plan, like? Gerry!
All right, I've worked it out. It doesn't seem like we're going to get our tickets this season. So how's about this? If we can't afford two, then maybe we can just get one and share it. You know, me 1 week, you the next, or I have first offs, you have second, or maybe... Oh, my favourite programme. It's great. You always see someone you know.
Have you seen these two teenagers? They work as a team, one about 5 feet tall, the other over 6 feet. Here, the taller one poses as a blind person as they steal goods in Newcastle city centre. There's a cash reward for information leading to their arrest. They appear to own a rusty-coloured, long-haired dog. The taller of the two wears a bench coat of the kind football managers wear. If you recognize these youths, please call us now.
Oh, shite, man. They may as well have read out our bloody names. Rusty and all. Even your friggin' bench coat got a mention. The whole of time, side will be out looking for us now.
What are we gonna do, like?
It's pure and simple, Sewell, man. First off, we've got to, well, you know, get rid of it. I like it as much as you, but it's a dead giveaway, man.
I can't do that.
You've got to, man. It's dangerous. You have to get rid.
I can't do it. I've had it for 4 years.
What?
Me bench coat. I've had it for over 4 years.
It's not your bench coat. There's something else that's got to go.
Oh, you can't mean it.
That Matthew kid will have seen us.
I can have him easy.
He's a Raji man, a pure psycho.
I can't do it.
I can do me bench coat. I've had a push, but I can't do that. You do it. I can't. You do it.
Don't worry. It's for the best.
I love that dog.
Sorry it's got to end this way, Rusty. But we can't have people seeing you now, can we? You've been a really nice dog. But you also a dead giveaway. You've been a good dog. But, well... You know.
You all right, Cherry?
Where have you been all this time? Where have you been sleeping?
Flaws, mainly. Flaws, friends.
What you want?
Oh, man, Cherry. Tack, E, wobbly eggs, poppers, smack. What about you? Still going mental on tack?
No, I've stopped off for a bit.
Carrying now?
I told you, man,
Rachel. You must have something, Gerry. I know what you like. You must have something on your tack. Anything. I'm your sister, man. I'm desperate. Couple of quid, anything. I'm away. I'm begging you, man. I need help. You fuck. How's Mum?
She misses you, Manbridge. We're all do. We've moved again, and this time he won't find us. It's a canny flat, like you should see it. And I've sorted out your room, put all your stuff in and that. Put your poster up on the wall.
It doesn't matter where it is. It's not home anymore. This is my life. This.
Manbridge, man, come back and do all them things what we used to.
Aye. So can me dad.
I'll look after you.
Wasn't just his fists, you know, Gerry. Gerry.
Bridgman, just come back. Let us tell you where the flat is.
Gerry, I don't want to know. Anyway, what are you doing around here?
Having a day out, like. With Sewell.
Sewell? Is he still wearing that bench coat?
I bloody hope not. Do you want a burger? I'll get you a burger, eh?
Deep down, you're still nothing but a bloody angel, aren't you?
I'm not losing it, Gerry, man. I've decided. I'll wear it inside out, but that's the limit. Besides, it helps with that other matter. I've been thinking about that too, and it's sorted. All I've got to do is wear them.
Wear them?
You know, under me bench coat, like.
What are you on about?
You big, soft lad, yeah. I knew you couldn't do it. Time to a post, like. Is that the best you could do?
We can't keep on your bench coat forever.
No, I know. Just till Gates said. Then I'll give him the Gemma to look after for us. Till it's all blown over, like.
Gemma?
Aye. Seeing her now, man.
You're joking.
Why?
Well, you're you, and Gemma's Gemma. Anyway, she's engaged to that orangutan man.
No. That's all over, that is.
Oh, aye. Well, the only question now is who's going to pull your head out your arse first? Mad Dog Matthew or Gemma's fella?
I'm Gemma's fella.
He's an ice hockey player, you know.
So?
So? Have you not seen them on the telly? They're gone fucking mental. And it's not like he'll come after you on his own. He'll have the whole squad with him.
Puffs, man. I can have that lot. Shearer shoots! 1-0! Hey, Gerry man, this time next year, eh? Eh?
This time next year, you'll be dead. With a puck in your gob and a hockey stick up your arse.
Shearer! 2-0! What are you thinking, Gerry man? It's a mad plan, this, Gerry.
Well, we'll never find out, will we? If we miss the bloody bus.
Oh, wait, 2 minutes, man. I just said I'd see you for 2 minutes.
Harry, lads.
Harry.
Hey, you look smaller than you do on telly.
You bench coats all like. Good time.
So, well, Pet, I've got you some bait. It's mostly for you, because I know you'll eat the most being so fat, like. But it's for you and all, Gerry. A few doorsteps and a couple of cans.
Ain't you the best, man?
I don't know. You TV celebs get all the perks, like.
How are you, Sewell? I need a word.
They're shagging, like.
What are you? Inspect that fucking moss, like.
So where he's going?
Nowhere.
Is that what the careers officer said to you, like?
Gerry, man. Bag of lucky dip.
Nah.
How are you, man? 5, I like.
Nah, Sewell and me's off all that now, like.
Why, like?
Oh, is Sewell, man. Let's get going.
fuck. Psycho bollocks.
Sewell man, is Raji off his head? For God's sake, fucking run!
See ya.
Don't ye move, man! Don't ye fucking move! You took me dog. He's mine, and you took him. Mine! I didn't take him, me fuck.
I didn't take him.
He followed us.
Stay here.
See you later, Gemma.
See you, Sewell.
What about the hound? Oh, you can't leave Rusty, man. You love a man, you'd have bloody gate.
Got someone else to love now.
What's so funny, like? What you smiling at?
I'm just happy, man.
Hi, more like. What you want?
Life, man. Just life.
She's still looking after us, man, Sewell, eh?
This lot's after season tickets and all, do you?
No. Anyone else is that smart. Give us a pair of season tickets.
One'll do, like, if you can't manage two. Oh, Gerry, man, what did you expect?
Respect, man. I'll make them take notice of us.
Yeah. Gerry, man, what are you doing?
Get in.
Gerry, man.
Just get in, will you?
Gerry, I don't think this is one of your better... Gerry, man.
What?
This isn't any old fanny magnet. It's Alan bloody Shearer's fanny magnet.
Eh?
This is all his fan mail here, look. We're in Alan Shearer's bloody mortar, man.
Aye. Well, that'll teach him to laugh at us. Our soul, man. He's got a CD player. Stick one in, man. What's he got?
Oh, no, Alan.
What?
It's all the old tarts, man. Desiree. Natalie Umbruliulia.
Gabrielle. You know that slapper with a patch?
Oh, no, Alan.
What now?
Celine friggin' Dion?
We've got a record somewhere.
What kind of record, man? It's Shearer's.
Well, we kind of keep driving it for the same friggin' reason.
Great plan, Gerry, man. Go and ask Alan Shearer for a pair of season tickets and end up twatting his bloody mortar.
Hey, but, man, at last, eh? Eh?
At last what?
For me to tell my grand bands. I want you here forever. I can't believe it, but I know that you're real. I know what I want, and baby, it's you. Can't deny my feelings because they are true, yeah. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm with you. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong. Dreams can come true. It's gotta be around here somewhere.
What?
Newcastle. I'd see you
sometimes on your morning. Sewell, man, have you ever wondered why we are like we are?
What? Bloody hungry and fucking lost?
No, I mean, what decides, like?
You're gonna be brainy, you're not. You're gonna be lucky, you're not. You're gonna have not.
What, like, you're gonna be Bobby Robson, you're gonna be Hullet?
Aye, you're gonna be top drawer and you're gonna be scum. Cos that's what we are, you know.
Aye, top drawer.
Jesus, man, what are you doing?
If I wanted to listen to a whining arsehole, I'd fart, man. Oh, wait, are you going for a dip? Builder, man, it's purely Builder! Come on, man, get your kit off!
It's freezing! It's fucking freezing, man!
It's cushy! Scabby donkey, me.
Aye, and all we've got is scabby fish. So where'd you learn that, like, fishing with your mitts?
Dad learned us when I was a bairn, like.
Did he learn you lots of stuff, you old man?
Me dad's not me old man.
I live with me granddad. I just call him me dad. I never knew me real dad or me mum.
What happened to him?
Nowt. They just went away, like. I was just something that they didn't need.
Do you not, you know, want to find them?
I'd only kill them.
At least that's what I was on about. You know, what makes you what you are. Maybe that's it. A good dad. One that loves you. Wants you in that.
A good dad. That's what I'm gonna be.
Aye, me too.
No, Gerry, man. I mean, soon. I'm gonna be a father, Gemma's, you know.
You sure it's yours?
Fuck off. Gemma's a lady.
Gemma's Gemma, and she's 15.
So we'll have longer together.
You could always, you know, I mean, it's not too late. To...
Gerry, man, I'm happy about it, right? Dead happy. Happier than I've been about anything else in my whole life. Right.
Jesus, man, what's that? I thought we'd give all it up for our season tickets.
No team's that good, Gerry, man. Gerry, man, the season ticket thing. That was just about having a bit of fun, like, wasn't it? Something to do.
Was?
It was great, but it was just a game. Just dreaming of better things, like being something. I don't have to dream anymore.
Couldn't just nick a bit of that ribbon off you, could I?
Of course you can, look.
$2.22. Length of steps, it's 39. Those lovely legs, 11. Top of the shop, line 90. Two by
Gerry, married son. I only need one. I only need number 8.
Jesus.
8, come on, this is it, number 8. 8, 8, 8.
I'm sure, number 9.
Oh, fuck! Fuck, fuck, fuck! It's the university of life, son. You've just graduated.
How's four, number 9? Can you put any more cards on number 9?
You all right, Mum?
I think I'm sick this time, son. Doctor says you'll be all right. How does he know? He's only 11. No, son. I think I'm knackered. Gerry Pillars, get some rest, are you? I'm tired.
Two now, like.
I'm 15, man. I can't handle all that stuff. I had to do it, Sewell. I had no choice. If he'd found out, that would have been it. Sewell, man, you're a dead nice lad, and I love you loads. It's just, Zach's got a job, a future, and you've got... I've got a chance, you know, a real chance. To have a decent life. You understand that, don't you? Sewell?
All those lonely
you should do. You put her there.
And I guess I never told you.
Dad!
I'm so happy that you're mine.
Dad!
Oh, just fuck off, son, eh? If I said you were second best, girl, I'm so sorry I was blind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. So tell me that our true love hasn't died. Girl, tell me. Give me one more chance to make you satisfied.
Fuck, Sewellman, what happened?
You should see the state of them. What are you doing, man, Gerry?
I'm like you, man, Sewell. Still waiting for them better things.
Proud of yourself, you big fucking twat! You were meant to see us through, man!
So what made you come here?
I don't know.
It's the only way, man. The whole lot in one job, one big job, we're there. Are you with us, man, Sewell?
I'm with you, Gerry. When though?
Today.
Today?
Now.
Now? Where?
Dunno. Wherever we are when we finish the song.
Eh?
No turning back, mate.
No turning back.
Be great, man. We're sitting in our own seats. We go to every match.
Ah, me lads. Sure to see us gunning.
Aye. Drinking our tea. Two sugars. Dead milky.
Passing the folks along the road just as they were standing.
Want to tell us what to do.
Belder.
Truly Belder.
Lads and lasses there, always smiling faces. Going down the Scotswood Road to see the blind races.
Fuck. Gerry, man, are you sure?
No turning back, right?
Aye, but what's the plan like?
There isn't one. Take your jacket off.
Playing at? You look like you're robbing the bank.
No, just cold, like.
How's your mom? I hear she's had a turn, like.
She's all right. Look, we can't stop any more. We're in a rush, like.
Aye. No rest for the wicked, eh? See you then.
See ya. Stay here.
A moment, the bank.
Next window, please.
You're not the bank.
Sorry?
Give us £1,000.
You got an account number?
No, but I've got a fucking gun.
Oh, come on now, son. I mean, a joke's a joke.
This isn't a fucking joke. I'm serious. Love us again and I'll blow your fucking head off. Now give us £1,000.
Give him the money or this fella gets it.
Just £1,000.
Yeah.
You only want £1,000?
Yeah.
How do you want it?
What? How do I want it? I don't know. Quickly.
Well, I've only got 300 in my drawer. I'll have to go back there and get the rest.
All right. But don't you dare press any buttons.
That's just a cord. You haven't got a gun.
You can't be sure.
Pretty sure. There's nothing in there.
Come on, come on!
Not 100% sure though, are you?
99.
Well then,
take a walk if you feel lucky. Do you feel lucky, punk?
Actually, I do quite.
Gerry man.
Oh, don't use your freaking name, Sewell man. Oh, shite!
Only for our tickets, that's all. Nearly a fucking year, and this is all we've got.
We're gonna split it like 50-50.
It's not funny, Sewell man.
We can give it to me dad when he visits. He can bury it somewhere. He'll never remember where he buried it like, but if he did, we could escape and fly to Spain, splash out on a couple of season passes to Juventus.
Two teas.
Can I have mine more milky?
Which one's my carton?
Me.
The hospital's been on. There's some bad news, like.
In the silence of this hour, speak to us of eternal things, that through patience and comfort of the scriptures, we may have hope and be lifted above our darkness and distress into the light and peace of thy presence. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now we say a final farewell to a much-loved and fondly cherished member of our community, a loyal friend, a doting father, a loving husband, cruelly taken from us during a moment's lack of concentration, crossing the Inner Ring Road late last Thursday night. We will all miss Billy McCartan.
Thank fuck the bus driver didn't.
Please all stand for the hymn, Now Thank We All Our God.
Despite having heard very positive accounts regarding the characters of these two youths, it would be remiss to ignore the gravity of this particular misdemeanor.
Your spelling's coming on.
However, the evidence heard plainly indicates that this was hardly the work of hardened criminals. Indeed, the fact that the accused put a ceiling limit on their cash demands leads one to suspect that this was quite clearly a first-time effort. In the hope that it will also be a last time, I sentence Gerald McCartan and James Sewell each to 200 hours community service over the next 12 months.
It'll fly by.
Are you on, Miss Whittaker?
Thank you.
Here you are, Mrs. Snowden.
Thank you, dear.
Sorry, Barrowpet. You?
All the better for seeing you, like. Come in, come in.
Here you are, Barrow.
Thanks, me little angels. Hey, it's nearly time, lads. Your tea's on the side there. I'll see you later.
Thanks, Barrow.
See you later, Barrow.
Belder, eh?
Aye, purely Belder.